The Mechanobiology Institute is a unique place. It was founded about 5 years ago with a vision of bringing together this merger between physics, engineering, biology, and chemistry.
Mechanobiology is a new term for the physics of cellular interactions and is another form of quote-unquote physiology. What we are really trying to understand is at a molecular level, how does a cell know where it is in a tissue and how does it know how to behave properly in terms of the mechanical environment of that tissue?
Singapore is one of the few places in the world that's willing to take that risk, to take an area that's not yet mainstream in biology or in physics, but believe in the people that are setting up the institute and believe in the quality of the science that will be produced and then later in the outcome and the technologies.
The vision for the institute was that it would be an environment where groups of engineers, biologists, and physicists and chemists could interact in an interdisciplinary fashion to approach the problems of how do cells mechanically interact with their environment. This is relevant to a number of disease states such as cancer, cardiovascular disease, and the issues with aging.
I think one of the unique features or the strengths of MBI is of course the people. We've been lucky and able to recruit really highly motivated a group of people, and then it's not just that they're each motivated for their own project, but there's a real team spirit here. And they feel as part of one institute that's working for a common goal. And so in some senses, like although there are many different groups, we're all one big team here.
We have multiple labs who all work together, and we all have different specialties. We bring all techniques together. Even in an individual lab, like in Mike's group, we have a Drosophila biologist, and we have a chemist like me, we have a material scientist. We all put things together, and that's where it makes the MBI very unique. And you can push yourself out of your comfort zone to learn a few things from different people in different fields, and that's what makes you grow.
I think that MBI is the best platform for doing interdisciplinary sciences. In my whole life, I have never seen such an institute which has people from all different disciplines of maths, physics, chemistry, computing, mechanical engineering, and everything. So physicists do not need to be afraid of biology anymore, and so biologists do not need to be afraid of physics anymore. We can teach each other things just like friends.
What we were trying to do was provide this open lab environment where the interdisciplinary interactions could occur. Labs were not in silos. An engineer could talk to a biologist, and that's really where a lot of innovation can occur. My own lab has been looking at the stretching of substrates and the effects of even a 1% stretch, which you and I do as we walk on the growth and the behavior of systems.
One big part of my area of research actually involves developing microfluidic devices and using cell mechanics principle to detect and diagnose diseases such as malaria and cancer. This microfluidic devices is able to enable the blood as it routes through the special design channels to separate the larger and stiffer cancer cells from the smaller and more deformable blood cells. So once these cancer cells are collected, the clinicians can actually conduct more detailed genetic analysis of such cancer cells, and thereafter to determine any specific mutation that the person may be suffering from. If these mutations are druggable, clinicians can then administer the right drug to the patient at the right time.
My lab works on how cell mechanical constraints alter nuclear architecture and thereby impinge on genome regulatory programs. So our lab has taken an interdisciplinary approach in thinking about how cells in the local microenvironment perceive mechanical signals, transduce the signals to the nucleus, and how within the nucleus, very modular designs in genetic regulatory programs are set up.
The lab at MBI is very interested in the interface between cell biology and mechanobiology. In particular, we are very interested in the role of membrane dynamics. So as you probably know, membrane is extremely plastic, so that makes it a very challenging problem to study. But at the same time, it's very important because all the biochemical reaction we know either happens on the membrane or, you know, happens in a compartment that's created by lipid bilayer. So understanding how membrane is organized is essential for us to understand how cell works, essentially.
My main research area is actually to try to understand and visualize how the microenvironment surrounding cells affects the way that cell-cell interact with each other. Based on new ways of controlling the microenvironment around cells in 3D and controlling as much as possible the different parameters of this microenvironment that the cell feel around them. It involves also optics, because once you control the microenvironment, you also want to be able to visualize the cell-cell interactions are changed. We managed to do super resolution imaging, deals down to 2/10 of nanometers in resolution, but we managed to do that in 3D over the whole cell body.
MBI is an excellent platform for us to interact with various scientists. There are many visiting scientists that visit our institute, and we have the opportunity to speak to them directly and share our ideas and also networking with them.
For myself as a visiting professor at MBI, the ability to interface again with this multidisciplinary institute that we have has enhanced my research in absolutely every aspect, and to perform experiments and move in ways that we never could have individually.
Here in MBI, we really are doing new, exciting research. We're discovering new areas, new answers to old problems. It's not me too kind of research. We're really having a lot of fun being very innovative.
We have an initiative in the area of skin. We have initiatives in cancer and in regeneration stem cells. We see ourselves playing a major role in trying to take the understanding of the mechanics and now applying it to a number of different disease situations for the future.